All right, now to a story that we've been following for quite a while about the man who showed up to a public land auction with the intention of protesting, or at least causing a stir there to shed some light on climate change. You see, this is a national park land in Utah, and it was going to be sold by the U.S. Bureau of Land Management to, wait for it, oil and gas companies. Well, instead, this 27-year-old man ended up bidding on the land, driving up the prices, and winning many of them. Well, when President Obama came into office the following year, he invalidated that auction. But even after that, Tim DeChristopher was convicted in a Salt Lake City federal court for making nearly $2 million in false bids at a federal auction. Today, he is scheduled to be sentenced. Kevin Zeese is the director of comehomeamerica.us and has been very outspoken about this case. And Kevin, thanks so much for coming on. From what I understand, Tim DeChristopher faces up to 10 years behind bars for what seems to me, at least, to be an act of civil disobedience. Is that right?
That's right. It was an act of civil disobedience that stopped an illegal sale of leases to the oil and gas industry. The sale was illegal, and not only did the Obama administration stop it after DeChristopher bid on the lands, but they reviewed the leases that were up for sale and found that almost all of them would have been illegally leased. What this was a rush to try to get sales done by the Bush administration to their friends in the oil and gas industry before the Obama administration came into power. And Tim DeChristopher, there had been a lawsuit filed that wasn't making any progress, and Tim DeChristopher took it in his own to stop this illegal leasing of oil and gas lands.
And I know yesterday RT spoke to Tim DeChristopher about some of the broader issues of his case. And here he is in the big picture last night talking about how corporatism is almost always the big winner. I'll play a bit of it and then we can talk about it.
Great. And the legal system, the criminal justice system, is a tool of those in power. And so we shouldn't necessarily expect that tool to be used against those that are controlling our government. I think holding corporations accountable is more our job than it is the legal justice system's job. And we should be looking for other ways to do that besides just, you know, hoping for some U.S. attorney somewhere to indict some bankers or oil executives.
So pretty interesting, Kevin. I mean, we live in the United States of America, and here Tim is, this environmental activist, saying it's our job. Why is this not the legal system's job?
Because we have a corrupted government, and Tim DeChristopher serves on a steering committee with me for a project called October2011.org. October2011.org is an effort to bring Americans to Freedom Plaza in Washington, D.C. in October to hold the government accountable and to end corporatism, exactly what Tim is talking about. We're going to have a Tar Heel Square type of rally. We're going to occupy Freedom Plaza, and we're going to demand an end to corporatism and militarism. And people have to be more than citizens on Election Day. We have to be citizens every day. There's a constant work that needs to be done to challenge the corporate state. And Tim is one of those real amazing leaders who has stood up and now is willing to take the punishment. My hope is that he doesn't go to jail at all, but the Obama administration is actually trying to make an example out of him. They're actually trying to get a lengthy sentence and a gigantic $1 million fine against him for stopping an illegal sale. He stopped something that was illegal, and yet the Obama administration wants to put him in jail for years for stopping the law from being violated.
It's pretty interesting. I know this is a case that all eyes have been on, at least from the environmental community. It hasn't been discussed very much, certainly on the mainstream media, and people are confused about it. What do you think are some of the biggest misconceptions? I mean, if the Obama administration indeed is making the case, the U.S. Attorney's Office is making the case that, you know, he did something illegal and therefore should be punished for it, regardless of whether the auction, you know, was validated or not, this is someone who was doing false bidding. Talk about that.
Well, this was an obviously illegal sale. There's not even a question about it. And when it was reviewed, Tim was right. What should have happened was this should have been stopped before the sale occurred by a court, and now then the court should have investigated, or the government should have investigated who was pushing this illegal sale, and those people should have been prosecuted. Tim DeChristopher shouldn't be made into a hero for this. Now, we don't expect the corporate media to cover this fairly, because this is anti-corporate. This is challenging corporate power and corporate and government working together to further enrich big business. And so we don't expect the corporate media to cover it. We really appreciate RT for covering it. Thank you for being there, because I think Tim DeChristopher needs to be known by people. He is a hero to many. And what he says today is, The key thing is don't be intimidated. Use this injustice to fight injustice more.
Well, and I know Tim has also said he would rather go to jail and serve time than be inactive, than sort of lie down. But why then are there not more Tim DeChristophers? Why is this such an individual case, and why do so many people accept the status quo?
Well, in fact, people aren't accepting the status quo. And I'll send you an email after this show to show you the types of videos of protests going around across the country, all parts of the country, on all sorts of issues, from foreclosure on homes, for banks not paying their taxes, for schools being closed.
But things are not changing.
Well, they're not changing because the corporate media is not covering this. If you looked at what's really going on in the United States right now, you would think America was in revolt, but it's not being covered. Tim DeChristopher is one of many. There are many Americans who said this enough is enough. It's time for Americans to stand up and take back our government.
All right. We will keep on this case, of course, and bring an update later today on what that sentence turns out to be. Director of Come Home America, U.S., Kevin Zeese. Thanks so much.
Thank you.